In this video tutorial, we are going to build an application that uses Java SWT, Standard Widget Toolkit, together with MindFusion's Schedule Library for Java Swing. We demonstrate how to handle user integration both ways. Interaction on the SWT UI, which notifies the Swing calendar, and interaction in the calendar, which must trigger update to the SWT UI. The sample is a simple month calendar with two buttons. One creates new appointments, and the other just shows the total number of events on the calendar. The buttons are SWT widgets. We download the archive with the SWT widgets from the official Eclipse page. Then we follow the steps from the tutorial, Developing SWT Applications Using Eclipse. We choose Import from the File menu, and then Projects from Folder or Archive. We open Import again, this time, existing projects into Workspace. Here is the SWT Widget Toolkit, added as a project in the solution tree. We create a new Java project called SWT Calendar. From the Properties menu item of File, we choose the Java Build Path option, and there the Projects tab. In it, we add reference to the project with the SWT Toolkit. With that, we are ready to use the widgets into our new Java application. We right-click on the SRC folder and choose New and then Package. Let's name our package mindfusion.swt.sample. We add a new class to it, which we call MainDisplay. Now, if we navigate to the project folder on the hard disk, you can see that Eclipse has created the necessary subfolders according to the package name and has placed the Java file for the new class in the right one. We add the main method in the class, and there we create a new display. We also create a shell and set its title. The layout will be row layout. Then we create a new composite widget with the shell. We can use now the SWT-AWT bridge to create a new frame with the composite as a parameter. we create an AWT panel with border layout and add it to the frame. Since the composite will be rendering the calendar, let's use the row data object to provide it with a large size. Let's create now a new folder called libs. There we copy the jplanner jar file that represents the scheduling library. It is included in the product archive, which you can download from MindFusion's website. Then we create a new instance of the calendar class. Before we continue, let's use the context menu to add the jplanner jar to build the path of the project. We set the light theme as theme for our calendar. We add now the standard code to open the shell and render the display. Here is our calendar. We can create events, navigate through dates, enjoy all the features provided by the library out of the box. Let's add now a button. When clicked, a new event will be created programmatically in the calendar. The button will be an SWT widget. We add now a new class to handle the creation of calendar events. Let's name it Utility. The class needs access to the display, calendar, and button from the main method in the main class. Before we go on, let's look at the Eclipse article that teaches us about the integration of SWT and AWT. What we are doing now falls into the case of running a task on the AWT thread from the SWT application. So we need to use swing utilities invoke later or invoke and wait methods. we create a new method called updateProgress, and there we call invoke later. We initialize a new runnable instance as a parameter to this method call. Then we use the method getFirstVisibleDate of the calendar to get exactly the first date in the month that is rendered. We create a second date that is 7 days after the first one. Those two dates will mark the start and end of each calendar appointment we create through code. We create an instance of the utility class so that we can call the method that creates calendar appointments. We now add EventListener for the click event of the button. This is standard code, how you handle event on an SWT widget. In the event handling code, we make a call to the updateProgress method, which is expected to create events programmatically. Let's run the application. We click the button and here is the event. We click second time and another event is added. So, we have now the code that communicates from the SWT widget to the AWT calendar. Let's add the code that handles interactions in the opposite direction. Suppose we want to know the count of events on the calendar. We will add a button that will display that number, no matter if the event was created in code or through user actions. Let's add a new button, which is a copy of the current button but with different text. We provide it as a parameter to the utility class. Now, in this case, we want to update an SWT widget from the AWT control, and we need to use the display.asyncexec or display.syncexec methods to schedule the work. In utility, we will add a method that changes the text of this button based on the count of appointments in the calendar. We add a new method called updateButton. There we call displayAsyncExec, and in it we create a new thread. In the run method, we check if the display is still active. If yes, we update the text on the button, the second button, to render the count of the events in the calendar. Let's call this method from update progress. This way, we will see the count of events being updated every time we create an event programmatically. And that's exactly what happens, but it is not enough. The count is updated when we click the first button, but does not change when events are created by the user through typing. When the user deletes an event, the count also changes, but the change is currently does not trigger update of the button text. In order to reflect those changes, we need to handle the item created and item deleted events on the calendar. They are members of the Calendar Adapter class. We add now a new calendar listener with a new calendar adapter. There we handle item created and item deleted in the same way. We call the update button method on utility. Let's run the application. Now if we create an item directly in the calendar, the count of items increases. If we click the button, the count of items increases again. We delete an item, and the count goes down. Everything works as it should, and this is the end of this tutorial. Thank you for watching, and thank you for your interest in MindFusion Developer Tools.